Our plan is to effectively integrate the various segment aspects of PRP and insolvency legislation into a coherent and efficient framework, improving the effectiveness of the judiciary system and cleaning the household's insolvency backlog. The new single insolvency framework will utilize innovative tools such as electronic platform with digital processes for debt restructuring, pre-agreed debt settlement proposals between creditors, a credit bureau for data collection and sharing, early warning, as well as certified corporate evaluators, financial experts, and mediators alleviating costs. Sixth priority, to broaden the tax base. The 30% electronic transactions requirement will deliver on this objective. First, it will broaden the tax base across types of taxpayers as more income will be declared by self-employed professionals and SMEs. Second, it transforms the tax threshold from an unconditional to a conditional benefit, thus broadening the tax base among the largest tax groups of wage earners and pensioners. In addition, we progress on e-invoicing and e-books. We reform the real estate zones of objective values. We regulate and we closely monitor short-term tenancies markets. We digitalize the independent authority for public revenues. Seventh priority, to implement policies safeguarding the stability of the financial system with George Zavos. We have made significant progress to introduce the Hercules Asset Protection Scheme. It is a market-based voluntary model similar to the Italian securitization scheme, allowing banks to transfer securitized NPLs into an SPV.